Well, my involvement in D-Day was to be an upper deck hand on the Belfast.
My job was a coxswain with a frogman to blow the obstacles up. We landed on the 5th of June, midnight.
When you think of inventions during the Second World War, you think of the bouncing bomb, you think of radar, but for my money, Mulberry Harbours are right up there. They're a classic example of British ingenuity and inventiveness.
Vast artificial harbours, secretly prefabricated in Britain by thousands of workers, helped to make possible the invasion of Normandy. Two fully equipped ports, as large and impregnable as Gibraltar, with huge steel and concrete cassoons looking like floating blocks of flats, these were built in 7 months and towed to Normandy in sections 3 days after our landings.
We wondered what they were at first when we saw them. What are they going to do with them? We're going to load men and beetles on them. We were surprised they towed them all that way. But the soldiers were glad to get in a lorry and drive off at Mulberry Harbour instead of getting in a landing craft and getting wet through. Speed was the essence.
It is so much better if a lorry can land onto a pontoon that doesn't rock about all over the place with the possibility of you tipping into the sea. They want to get you ashore and get you into action.
War is all about logistics. It's getting your petrol, your men, and your machinery to the front line. The Germans had ruined all the existing harbours and nobody knew whether they could be used. You needed these artificial harbours to guarantee all that equipment coming on shore.
When I look back over my career in the Navy, I felt I spent more time fighting the sea than I did the Germans. You could never rely on it. It always turned one way or another. The harbours minimised the possibility of this. And you can't have a better contribution than that, in my opinion.
If both Mulberry Harbours had failed, the consequences could have been catastrophic. You've got to remember that one Mulberry Harbour alone landed 2.5 million men and 500,000 vehicles. Just imagine what difference that would have made if they hadn't gone into the Allied war effort. That's a big difference.
Importantly, a great idea. A very great idea. I don't know whose idea it was, but they were a clever fellow.